Hobson said he ain't got no shame. This album was pretty much what I expected it to be. I mean, I knew he was gonna be like telling a lot of stories on this one. You know what I'm saying? Like, it starts off as like he telling a story about like the incident when he was in Australia. He had an altercation with his baby moms. Yeah. I didn't even know Hobson actually had a son. I don't know if it was like, it's like, it sounded like he speculated throughout the album if it's even his child or not. But, yeah, like, so, it was that, and then, you know, it's always got the joints where he just, like, ripping the beat to shreds, you know what I'm saying? I think my favorite song is either Black Sheep with Eric Tucker or I Must Be On Something. You know, Black Sheep, he was just talking about growing up, you know, not fitting in with any of the crowds at his school or anybody around him, which, you know, anybody who knows me knows that's something I can relate to. You know, always being the outsider. I Must Be On Something, you know, basically just talking about, you know, like, how his mind frame just is always fucked up. Which is also something I can relate to, you know. Some other songs on here that I liked were Right Here, Twisted, I Wouldn't Do That, The Purge, Panorama City with Joey T. That was kind of cool. Kind of had a G-Funk feel to it, which I ain't never really heard him do. I mean, I always, you know, I know you from Cali and all, but I ain't never heard him just do no G-Funk West Coast type style shit. Illmind 9 was funny as hell. It's kind of fucked up, but you know, still funny. Marcus Gospel was good. And Witch Doctor, which actually was not on the it's not on the actual CD, it's on the iTunes album. But it's not on here. Which I don't know why. Maybe it's because, I don't know, maybe he felt like Witch Doctor didn't like really fit the storyline or something. Yeah, Illmind 9, like, Hobson is so savage for that joint. That joint and Happy Ending. Like, I saw the Happy Ending video a while back. I was like, this nigga Hobson done flipped his lid. I don't know how he thought he was gonna get away with that. But shit. You know? It's, the No Words 2 skit was kind of funny. Just crazy, like, seeing, like, how the first No Words from Pound Syndrome. I didn't think he was going to actually do a video to that. And then that joint just went viral. You know what I'm saying? And like, I think people thought like Hobson was being, like everybody that wasn't a fan of Hobson thought he was actually being serious on that track. The No Words 2 on here, like, it actually sounds more mumbly. Joe Medulis. I don't know. I guess that's South African money or something. Of course, you know, you got the Slugs and Dame, you know, the Q and the Soup skill was funny, like, his baby mama called him after he got out of court, like, talking about you look cute and so, like, really, you gonna call my phone with this mess after you got me in, like, it seems like on this album, Hobson was actually owning up to a lot of his own mistakes as well, like, not just yapping about, you know, what everybody else did wrong to him, because like on this track on like this track called Money on the Side, where he was talking about, like, I don't know if it's a girl that was a side chick or just somebody he was messing around with, who was just, you know, basically prostituting herself. But, you know, there was that, and then, of course, Happy Ending, where he was talking about, you know, going into the Asian massage problem. A happy ending. I guess, you know, on this one, he kind of found a balance between, like, not only venting his frustrations about, you know, how a lot of other people have wronged him, but the way that he's wronged other people as well, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, Hobson, no shame.